Hello everyone and welcome to RS Kitchen. Once again, I'm here with the healthy recipe which can be used for breakfast or for supper or dinner. It's full of proteins. It's paneer and cheese paratha, which is cottage cheese and mozzarella cheese paratha. So let's get started. I have 50 grams of cheese grated here and I have 50 grams of paneer which is grated once again. And I'm going to add few things to it. Let's get started. I'm adding some chopped, very thinly chopped green chilies, some thinly chopped coriander leaves, and some salt as per the taste. Make sure that you add salt accordingly because cheese is already salted most of the times. So I'm adding a little salt. To which I will add black pepper powder. Black pepper goes very well with dairy products like cheese and paneer. I'm adding a little bit of red chili powder. It's optional. If you're making for kids, please avoid. Now I'm gonna add half a teaspoon of chaat masala. This gives a very nice and tangy taste to parathas. So we will mix it very well so that all the spices and paneer are mixed. So now if you want to make only paneer parathas, like only cottage cheese parathas, you can use this stuffing and make paneer parathas. But I'm mixing cheese with it because I'm going to make cheese and paneer parathas. They taste much better. I'm going to add 40 grams of grated mozzarella cheese. You can use cheese of your choice. I'm going to give it a nice mix, a final one. Don't mix it too harsh, be gentle, otherwise cheese will start melting. And if you feel that your cheese is a little sticky, please keep the stuffing in refrigerator for 5 to 7 minutes. But this one looks fine, so I will start making parathas. So I already have a filling ready here. I have made chapati dough and balls out of it, and here is my chapati dough. I'm going to press it with my fingers a little bit so that I can put in the stuffing in there. Not much, a little bit. I'm doing it with my fingers. If you want, you can do it with a rolling pin, but I find it better this way because it's pretty much even. Now I'm going to add 2 spoonfuls of the stuffing that we made. Now the quantity of the stuffing should be equal to the quantity of the dough that we have taken. That's the thumb rule for nice parathas. So here it goes. It's time to seal it. We will do a double sealing. This is how we are going to seal one side. And now we will double seal it from the other side, like this. Roll it, press it. Pressing it from all the sides to make the stuffing even inside, sprinkle some dry wheat flour and let's roll it. I like my parathas thin, not very thick, but if you like thick parathas, choice is your thin parathas will taste crunchy and very soft and better. So this is how gently I am rolling it from all the sides equally. And make sure that your stuffing doesn't fall off. With a lot of stuffing also you can make thin parathas if you're very gentle. This is how filling looks in my paratha. Time to bake it. So I put it on the hot griddle and we keep flipping it. This time I'm going to use butter because we have cheese and paneer in the paratha, so butter goes very well with it. A little bit of butter on each side. These parathas are really delicious, not very fancy. It's available, it's you can make it with the easy available ingredients in all the kitchens. So please try this. This is how my paratha looks like a balloon. Keep rolling it and keep scrolling it on the griddle, which is called khar lagana in Punjabi. That's good for parathas and it makes them very delicious. And once your paratha go up like balloon, that means the stuffing inside is cooked very well. It's ready. I've cut it into 4 pieces, each paratha, and I'm garnishing with the stuffing that I've filled in, which is cheese and paneer, with some coriander, chopped coriander leaves. This is how it looks. This is very healthy, very delicious, and lovely. I hope you guys like this recipe. Please try it and share your comments. Let me know what more you would like to see on my channel. I'm serving it with yogurt garnished with red pepper powder, black pepper powder, and coriander leaves. You can garnish it with pickle or whatever you like. Don't forget to subscribe and do share your comments. Thank you.